For those that are new, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on all notifications to be notified whenever a brand new video is posted onto this channel. Thank you all so much for your continued support. Now let's begin. With the Avengers 4 movie on the horizon in early 2019, the question on everyone's mind is what is going to be the end result between the Hulk and Thanos in the Avengers 4 movie? Now, having to look at the conclusive status of Hulk and Thanos in Infinity War, there's been lots of speculation as to what is going to be of the Hulk as he inevitably comes across Thanos in the upcoming movie, because there are certain variations in the comics where it blatantly points out the direction in which we are going to see Bruce Banner and the Hulk in the upcoming movie. Now, after having to look at what happened between Bruce Banner and the Hulk, we have to go back to Thor Ragnarok. Now, we understand that it's been several years since Bruce Banner had been the Hulk and reverting and staying in that form for quite some time until the end of Thor Ragnarok. Now, we get to see in Infinity War how Bruce Banner is running around. He's trying to get the Hulk to come out, but the Hulk just doesn't want to come out. Now, a part of that could be because of the end result of the Hulk having to be scared of Thanos. However, we also have learned based from the Russo brothers themselves that they have confirmed that that doesn't seem to be the case. However, I believe that the Hulk subplot for Avengers 4 is going to center itself around Banner and Hulk finally merging to become Professor Hulk. Now, the reason why this is so important is because Professor Hulk, aka Merged Hulk, is unquestionably one of the most powerful versions of the Hulk within the Marvel comics. Now, there are different versions of Hulk that we see that are simply more powerful than Professor Hulk, and two examples of that are Worldbreaker Hulk and, of course, Heart of the Monster Hulk. Now, Heart of the Monster Hulk is a concept where I don't believe they're going to adapt in the Avengers 4 movie, because Heart of the Monster Hulk is so powerful that in some variations in the comics, we see how Heart of the Monster Hulk is able to easily defeat Thanos with such incredible power that he wields, being at a very uncontrollable state. So it only makes sense for Bruce Banner and for the Hulk to have an inner conflict as they're trying to piece together as to what to do, as we get to see how Bruce Banner desperately calls upon the Hulk to show up, but the Hulk simply doesn't want to show up, because I do believe at the very end of the Avengers 4 movie, we are going to get to see the intelligent Hulk that we see in the comics. Now, this is very pivotal because it's going to be the raw, unmitigated power of the Hulk with his body, along with the mind of Bruce Banner, which ultimately substitutes for a very powerful being as opposed to having Worldbreaker Hulk. Now, to have a concept like either Worldbreaker Hulk or even Heart of the Monster Hulk to happen, something massive, something on a massive scale needs to happen to Bruce Banner and the Hulk for that to even come about. For example, witnessing Black Widow die, or something major that directly affects the Hulk's livelihood for him to be pushed to that very point, because Worldbreaker Hulk and Heart of the Monster Hulk are two different concepts, and we get to see how different adaptations can be added in the Marvel MCU, because it's arguable and up for debate that the Thanos that we see in the MCU is much weaker and nerfed in comparison to the Thanos that we see in the comics, which, to an extent, does hold truth. In the idea, going back to the concept of Worldbreaker Hulk, we get to see in the comics on Planet Hulk, Hulk believed that his wife and unborn child were killed, in which fueled him in such a way that allowed him to release that rage and that anger that fueled his vengeance and thus creating Worldbreaker Hulk. Now, they're not going to keep that exact concept the same if they were to do that in the MCU, because we haven't received any movie that involves a Planet Hulk. In seeing a Gray Hulk, a Red Hulk, in seeing different concepts of what happened in the comics be reflected onto the big screen, there is a licensing issue for the character of Hulk that is not fully owned by the proper people, in which thus we haven't seen a Hulk standalone film in quite some time. So to that, we have to rule out the idea of Worldbreaker Hulk actually happening in this movie, because Hulk doesn't have a wife, Hulk doesn't have an unborn child for him to cater to, as is in the comics, for him to release that inner anger in becoming the monster that we all know and love. So to that, the only other viable option is to have Banner and Hulk simply merge together in creating the ultimate being. And for that, the Hulk has to have his moment against Thanos for various reasons. Number one, to have payback. Now, we saw the incredible feats that Thanos had against Hulk in literally beating down the Hulk with his bare hands. Now, think about that for a moment. We've seen the Hulk endure so much, not only only in the Avengers movies, but also prior in the standalone films. The Hulk had endured so much that he always kept on pushing, no matter what, but in this case, it only took about 60 seconds for Thanos to beat the Hulk down into the dirt, to where we get to see Hulk dazed and confused as he was lifted up and sent to Earth. We see the fear in him. However, with that, we also go back to the first Avengers film, when we get to see how the Avengers collectively were at a huge disadvantage, until we get to see how the Hulk arrived in shifting the battle in favor of the Avengers during the course of Loki's invasion. And the Hulk at that given point had his moment with Loki. We get to see how the Hulk grabs Loki and he's pummeling him, he's slamming him all throughout the ground and calling him a puny god, but also seeing his incredible feats in taking on dozens upon dozens of invaders by himself. As we later on carry into the Avengers Age of Ultron movie, or Avengers 2, in which once again Hulk has his moment in fighting the Hulkbuster suit and fighting Tony Stark, but also manages to win. With that, also manages to stand up against Ultron's army by himself, taking on multiple copies as he's pummeling each machine into the ground. Fast forwarding from there, we go into Thor Ragnarok, and we get to see how once again Hulk is having more defying moments with Thor by his side, which ultimately carries into the Avengers Infinity War movie. And the only spotlight he ever had was getting beat down by Thanos. And we know that his anger can't get the best of Thanos in this situation, while Thanos has all six of the Infinity Stones, or the Infinity Gems referred to in the comics. But the only way to fight off such a being as powerful as Thanos would be to merge the body and the brain of Bruce Banner and the Hulk together in having to fend off against Thanos then. Now, the Hulk in the comics was written to become more powerful when the writers wanted to make a story with him go berserk and crossing over dimensions or smashing world just for the fans, for new ideas and excitement. Now, he's a movie character for now with feelings and a very long story arc that's going to reach its conclusion in the Avengers 4 movie. But I don't think that any of these directors are going to directly adapt from any of the comic concepts directly, because they will most likely do what they've been doing to a lot of other characters and villains lately, and that's grab various concepts from the comics and merging that within the MCU, which most likely will probably get to see a scene where Bruce speaks directly to Hulk in his mind, where they come to terms and they actually have some sort of an agreement for Hulk to actually assist the Avengers during the course of battle in merging Bruce's intelligence with Hulk's strength to face off against Thanos. Because remember, the arc of the Hulk is going to end in Avengers 4. Now, also remember that Mark Ruffalo had said that Ragnarok, Infinity War, and Avengers 4 are going to be kind of like a trilogy for Hulk. When in Ragnarok, Hulk had taken over 2 years and lived a good life of just being himself. Whereas in Infinity War, he was utterly destroyed by Thanos, and we get to see how Banner had to step up to save himself. It only makes sense that Avengers 4 includes both Banner and Hulk to come to an agreement in facing off against Thanos, but only then does the question beg, what happens to Professor Hulk as he goes up against Thanos? Now, I don't think that Professor Hulk is going to have any sort of remote chance in defeating Thanos. Let's make one thing perfectly clear. As long as Thanos has the Infinity Gauntlet with all of the gems and stones intact, Thanos wins. However, there is also rumors that Tony Stark is going to have a gauntlet of his own. And if you go back and remember Infinity War, we saw an extra gauntlet sitting there as Thor was talking to Rocket Raccoon. So it's foreshadowed that perhaps maybe Tony Stark is going to use that gauntlet, use the manipulation of time to gather stones of his own in defeating Thanos. Thanos could ultimately catch on in trying to stop them there, because we understand the gravity and nature of what would happen if the Avengers managed to have their own Infinity Gauntlet with all of the stones intact. That would be a problem for Thanos, but I do believe that by the end of this, it's going to be Professor Hulk who ends up getting the upper hand on Thanos, but it may not come as quick as you believe, because remember, we still have to merge the arcs between Banner and Hulk as the movie progresses. We can't just have them simply come to an agreement without there having to be a struggle, and there will be an internal struggle just as we saw in Infinity War, except this time on a much grander scale, in which both the Russo brothers have confirmed that this upcoming movie is going to break new grounds. And for the first time ever, we're bound to see two Infinity Gauntlets actually clash, and of course tying in multiple arcs, which one of the main ones happens to include the Hulk. Now again, for Heart of the Monster, for Worldbreaker Hulk, for Grey Hulk, Red Hulk, those concepts may never be introduced because we don't have any substance for standalone Hulk films that can easily transition and make their way into those stories as we carry on in the future of Avengers films, for example, Avengers 5, Avengers 6, Avengers 7, because we understand that those movies are bound to happen with some of the newer characters being introduced in the MCU, but Hulk for now, this could be a make or break moment for the Hulk character in the idea that he either takes the cake or he walks away in defeat. And for that, I don't think they're going to have Hulk walk away in defeat because he took one L already, so what's the purpose of giving him another one when he comes across Thanos again? And he will come across Thanos once more. But also in reference to Hulk, there have been several people making theories as to the idea of Maestro Hulk being introduced because there were concepts before of Maestro being introduced before Future Imperfect, but I don't think that Maestro Hulk would work in the current MCU. Not unless, of course, they give him enough buildup because we understand that Maestro Hulk in the comics is basically a warlord. And with that, he's very cunning in battle. He's a strategist, but I don't think that with the Infinity Gauntlet that has all the stones on it, would Maestro win. Now, maybe if you pit up Maestro against Thanos without the Infinity Gauntlet, something else as a result may happen, but I just don't see them going in the direction of Maestro Hulk, at least not yet, because again, that story is very rich in substance and the idea that the place where Maestro comes from in terms of Earth was destroyed by nuclear battle, nuclear radiation, nuclear war, so seeing Maestro's story come into effect may actually lead into a future film that's down the line, but not in the Avengers 4 movie. Heart of the Monster is something entirely different, and I don't think that they're gonna have time to basically tap into that story, but also we have to beg the question as to what the end result is going to be for Thanos in the Avengers 4 movie, if he's going to be killed, or if he's simply going to be sealed away. So in the end, guys, let me know your thoughts down below. What are your overall thoughts on Merged Hulk, aka Professor Hulk? If Professor Hulk does make his debut in the Avengers 4 movie, does he have a chance in defeating Thanos with or without the Infinity Gauntlet? What are your thoughts on Black Widow? Is that going to have any sort of effect on his life in allowing him to feel the pain of loss? Or do you guys think that perhaps maybe they could ultimately set up for a Worldbreaker Hulk down the line? Let me know your thoughts down below, guys. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys love the Avengers, slap a like on the video. If you guys love comics in general or Marvel, slap a like on the video. Tune back in for more if you guys are new. Hit that subscribe button, guys. Turn on all notifications. If you guys want to watch more discussions like this, make sure you guys click the description box. There is a playlist link down below where you guys can watch tons of awesome discussions. Thank you all once again for watching, and I'll be seeing you all in the next Avengers video. Take it easy, everybody. Peace.